Thank you very much, Rebecca. So the purpose of my speech today is to introduce the project and complete it with a team. This is what they call the High Performance Leadership Project at level 5 of ANYPATH. I think it's important for you guys to know that in Pathways, the first 3 levels are always all about communication. So we're preparing speeches and we're presenting them. The last 2 levels, so level 4 and level 5, are more focused on working on projects with people. So one part is speaking and the other one is doing. Today, I will share with you my plan and my vision for the project that I chose and why I chose it. The project will test my leadership skills, my planning knowledge, and mostly my ability to work with people. I chose it because, number one, it allows me to promote Toastmasters. Number two, it allows me to work with a group of people to implement it. And number three, it's a huge opportunity for me and them to learn, grow, and have fun along the way. So first things first though, the step number one, the very first step is to select my project. And I would like to talk about it. You see, I'm VPPR of our club, VP Public Relations. And so it just made sense for me to pick a project that I could promote. Therefore, I would like to officially introduce to all of you the 2021 District Conference. The District Conference is a large 3-day event. There's 1 day of registration and networking. That's the first one. Then the following day is a big day of learning, workshops, and socializing. Lots of learning in there. And the third day is the culmination of the district where we have the ability and the possibility to watch contestants compete on a large stage, and the winners of those contests are announced. So that's the contestants from the club, the area, the division, and ultimately district. So that's really an amazing opportunity. I attended those conferences in the past. I've had the opportunity to do so, and I can tell you they are always, always fun. And what's also fun is that they happen in various cities. And I participated in a contest, and I'm really pleased and somewhat proud, I guess, to say that I won the evaluation contest of that year. I've got the little prize that I earned myself when I did so. So this year, as I mentioned, it's happening between April 15 and 17. It's all free. Everybody can join, and it's all online. My job, for the purpose of this project, is number one, to work with the lead and the team that I built, and number two, to promote the event. My goals are very simple: to show leadership and excitement, and number two is to manage the scope of the event so it doesn't get bigger than itself. So now that I selected my project, let's talk about step number two, which is creating the strategy. I plan on promoting the event as an opportunity to, number one, to learn. As I said, there's going to be a lot of workshops the second day. Huge opportunities for learning. Number two is to network. Can you believe that there will be, on average, about 500 people in that Zoom meeting? If you think we're a big group, 500 people in that meeting is absolutely huge. And number three is to be entertained. As I said, there's going to be good quality contests and good quality contestants. So for me, though, there will be challenges. We have to remember that Toastmasters, our organization, is a volunteer organization. You constantly have to ask for help and support. You have to be clear and specific on the plan. You have to learn to delegate. You have to be always grateful and thank people for their time and effort. You have to share as much information as possible with the team, but mostly, I believe that you have to ensure that your project and your vision in your mind is clear to you and to them. So that's step number two, which is the strategy that I plan on working on. Now let's talk about step number three, which is putting the plan in action. This is actually the step that I'm currently in. My team has been created, I'm developing a strategy, now I actually have to lead the team. I have to provide support to them and be there for them. I have to provide learning opportunities for all. You know the infamous what's in it for me factor? We all abide by that, and it's all really precious to us. I want to learn something, you want to learn something, always. I have to show appreciation as the lead of the team, and I have to manage my time because there's a lot of work to do. And work-life balance, sometimes I have to admit, can get in the way. But asking people for help, for some of them, including myself, is not a given, and that's a bit of a challenge for me. But I'm learning along the way, as I said. So the next few weeks for me are going to be really challenging. I have to find time to work on it, number one. I have to constantly motivate people and be focused and disciplined. I have to be organized and decisive. But most of all, though, I have to be grateful and appreciative because I have to remember that it's a learning opportunity for all of us involved in that project. And people do offer their time for free. So that's something worth mentioning as well. You know, Toastmasters is an amazing organization and it has amazing programs. There's the communication part, as I mentioned, and there's also the leadership part. The leadership is the ability to inspire people. That's the one I'm in right now. And it's an ability to create an environment where visions are created and shared. But leading in a volunteer organization is quite different from leading at work. I think you can make the difference between a nonprofit organization and work. The environment, the cultures are completely different. You have to motivate and inspire people constantly in a nonprofit. And a leader who fills that definition and does it in a way that motivates and inspires others and gets people to participate and contribute to his project, in this case my project, is what they call a high performance leader. And that's what this project is all about, developing my leadership skills in a volunteer organization like Toastmasters. So over the next few weeks, you will hear me talk a lot about the district conference. If you have any questions, please get in touch with me. I will report back to you all in a few weeks about my experience and the lessons I've learned along the way. Back to you, Mr. Chair.